beyond where the horizon lies, where the horizon lies, and the land sinks into mellow blueness. Oh, please take me with you.
Let me skip.
I can dare myself. I'll put a pebble in my shoe and watch me walk. I can walk.
I shall call the pebble dare.
We will talk about walking. Dare shall be carried,
and when we both have had enough,
I will take him from my shoe, singing, meet your new road. Then I'll take your hand.
In the past weeks, we have been preparing for the celebration of Easter. We call this time of preparation Lent. The word Lent is an ancient word for spring. Lent is a season of hope and of new beginnings. It is a time for making promises to God and remembering God's promises to us. We have seen the signs and symbols of Lent. We have had our foreheads marked with ashes. We have made promises to change. We have been called to pray and to sacrifice so that we may follow Jesus more closely. We have been called to change our hearts through our good actions. Most importantly, we have been reminded that through the sacrament of baptism, we share in the new life of the risen Jesus. As members of God's family, we are asked to spread the message of Jesus to everyone we meet and to be a witness of Jesus by the way we live every day. As we approach Holy Week, we are reminded of all that Jesus did for us in order to give us a new life with him through his resurrection. As we watch the living stations of the cross, let us think about our Lenten journey and to look forward to the events that will happen during Holy Week.
How can we sing the Lord's song?
all we do here. You are first and foremost in our hearts, minds, and souls. What you did for us, out of love, is almost impossible to understand, but we cannot thank you enough. You are the greatest gift we have ever and will ever receive.
Jesus, we believe that you carried your cross to Calvary, and it was there that you died for our sins. Our sins. You did not have to do this, but your love for us is great and extends far beyond human understanding.
Through the way you lived your life, you have shown us what it means to be good, what it means to be holy, what it means to be the embodiment of love. As we begin this way of the cross with you today, we want everyone gathered here to understand what happened on that Good Friday so long ago, the magnitude of it. We know that you are present with us now, and we have faith that you will be with us in every step of our journey through life.
This is Jesus. This is the Jesus that we adore. This is the Jesus that we praise. This is the Jesus that we strive to be like. The Jesus that changed all of our lives forever. The Jesus that is the key to heaven. We ask you when we say, "We adore you, O Christ, we praise you," that you repeat, "Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world."
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross we have redeemed the world.
So this is how it all begins. Sentenced like a common criminal. Could these really be the same people who cried Hosanna and wanted to make me king only days ago? Now they're screaming for me to be crucified. Even the lies they've made up about me don't deserve this kind of punishment.
Jesus, without your help, we can be like Pontius Pilate. Sometimes we let fear sneak in and we do things we should not do. We know that we were not given a spirit of fear, but of strength. So we ask you to remind us that when we are hurtful to others, we hurt you too, just as Pontius Pilate and the people did long ago. Jesus, give us your strength to be strong in saying no when people ask us to do things we know we should not do. Give us a heart filled with love and not hate. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
We should glory in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, in whom is our salvation, life and resurrection, through whom we are saved and delivered. Though like Peter we
My name is Barabbas. I was thrown into jail because I tried to kill some Roman soldiers. Killing was not a big deal to me. Who cares about the life of another? Not me. So I was in jail when this man named Jesus was jailed beside me. There was a big holiday coming up in Jerusalem, and it was tradition of the Romans to let one prisoner go free. I knew it would not be me. I figured they'd let this guy Jesus go, but I figured wrong. There weren't many people who pleaded for Pilate to let Jesus go free, but many others hated Jesus. Who shall I set free?
Barabbas!
Barabbas!
Let him go! Free!
Barabbas? Did I hear that correctly? Barabbas. Barabbas was a terrible man. He was a criminal. And Jesus, on the other hand, had done nothing wrong. But I let fear get in the way, and I listened to the people. And so I was let go. I saw Jesus take up his cross. He did not say anything. He didn't scream or fight or even try to plead his case. How could this be? I hated my enemies, hated them. And yet Jesus seemed to love even those who were mean to him. How could a man like this exist? What would you have done if you were in my place?
Father, your will is what I want to do here. Give me the strength to carry this heavy cross, and with it, the injustices of the world. I know this is just the beginning of a tough and lonely walk, so please walk it with me.
Jesus, when Peter asked you how many times we have forgiven those who have hurt us, you replied, 70 times 7. What you meant by this was that we are to forgive people every time, every single time. You showed us 3 actions that we can do good to those who hurt us. We are able to turn the other cheek and show kindness. Jesus, that can be very hard for us to do. Sometimes we say mean things to other people. Sometimes we don't let them join our groups. Sometimes we may even hit or hurt them. But we understand that this is not what you would have done. This is not what you did. Jesus, please help us. Help us to be more like you. Help us to show kindness to all. You showed us the way of love. We ask you to help us be more like you. Loving, kind, and compassionate. Help us to be your hands and feet on earth. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because of our holy cross, you are redeemable.
Laden down under the weight of the wound.
next time.
How many times have I walked along here? I never dreamed it would turn out like this. Let me get up. Must get up. Will get up. Much further. More difficult. Wearing this cross.
Jesus, Herod called you a fool. He did not understand your ways. But we know that your ways are the only ways we should live. You will make all our paths straight. Sometimes we can be like King Herod. We want to have fun, and we want things to be easy for us. We do not like to have to suffer. For example, we may have a big test to study for, but since that's not fun, we might choose not to do the right thing. Jesus, please help us to learn that by carrying our own crosses, the harder things in our lives, we will become more like you. Help us to have faith at all times, to understand that blessings always come through times of trial. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
This is difficult enough on my own, but please, not in her presence. As much as it hurts me, I know it hurts her more. Mom, you don't deserve this. All you've ever done is love me. Please don't cry. I've got to do this.
Oh, Mary, what that must have felt like, we cannot imagine. No parent wants to see a child suffer. When Mary looked into Jesus' eyes, and saw love, the love she saw was for you, for me, for all of us. Isn't Mary's son wonderful? Jesus, our own families love us so very much, just as Mary loved you. We know how terrible it was for your mother to see you suffer. We ask you to help us to always be kind and respectful to our families. Open our eyes and hearts to see them as your messengers for us on earth, and open their eyes and hearts to help them understand that their responsibility is a great one, to teach us and raise us to know, follow, and love you always. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross and everything in the world,
my son.
times and had me down on my knees. There's always been someone to come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger to lend a helping hand. A message from a friend to say I understand. Ain't it kind of funny at the dark end of the road? Someone lights the way with just a single ray of hope. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love, to guide us with the light of love.
Station 5. Simon helps Jesus carry the cross.
My name is Simon. I'm just a farmer from the town of Cyrene. It was Friday morning, and I was coming up from the fields where I work in Jerusalem. I saw a large crowd gathered around. They were all gathered. Some were shouting, some were crying. I was curious, so I walked up to see what was happening. Suddenly, a Roman soldier came marching up to me and grabbed me. He forced me. Forced me to carry the cross for a man that had been condemned to death. I was so angry. I hadn't done anything wrong. I was just a poor farmer. Why were they forcing me to help this man? But then I saw his face, and he smiled at me. Smiled. After all that he had gone through, he actually smiled at me. Suddenly, the cross became a little lighter. My heart changed. I was now glad to help him carry his cross. This man, I could tell, was no ordinary man, and my life changed. It became so much easier and more rewarding to help anyone in their difficult times.
I don't know who you are, my friend, but thanks for helping me. I really need it right now. Every part of my body hurts from their beatings, but my heart hurts the most. Your name is Simon? Thanks, Simon, for leaving the safety of the crowd to help me.
Jesus, sometimes we feel lazy. Sometimes we see the people that are in need of help, but we make the choice not to help them. But you told us that you want your followers to serve others. Please, Jesus, we ask you to give us generous and loving hearts. Give us the heart and spirit to go out into the world and help others. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Day by day, oh dear Lord, three things I pray: to see thee more clearly, love thee more dearly, follow thee more nearly, day by day. Day by day.
Day by day, day
the same street that led to the place where Roman soldiers crucified their prisoners. I remember walking through my doorway when I saw Jesus. I remember him saying,
"As long as you give a cup of water to the least of my brothers and sisters, then you also give it to me."
I wanted to help him. I remember a Roman soldier walked up towards me and almost hit me. I should have been scared, but I was not. Oh, how Jesus looked at me with such love, love. And then I wiped the cloth away from his face.
"This woman is willing to take such a risk for me. Doesn't she see how crazy everyone is getting around here? She is liable to be punished for showing that she cares for me. It's comforting to know that others are taking the same risks that I've taken."
"Jesus, sometimes we may not even notice when people need our help. Veronica noticed. Please give us eyes that are always open to see how others need us. Give us hands that are always ready, like Veronica, to reach out and help those that suffer. Give us a heart for the people, our brothers and sisters in you. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world."
Salvation, life and resurrection.
and deliver.
Station 8. Jesus meets the women of Jerusalem.
We are a group of women from Jerusalem. We had heard Jesus speak a few times. Sometimes we would bake bread and give it to Jesus and his apostles for a snack. But then we saw him bleeding and wearing a crown of thorns. It was too much.
It was too much for us to see. It was terribly sad. But Jesus stopped. He turned to us and said,
"Do not cry for me. Rather, cry for your children and yourselves."
What does this mean? We did not fully understand what Jesus said, but we truly believed he was God's chosen one.
You women have understood so well and have been so kind. This is very good. Love one another. Take care of each other as you have taken care of me. Jesus, there are times we have witnessed and will witness suffering. Please give us hearts, like the women of Jerusalem, to feel for those that are suffering. Give us the courage to step up and help people. If we be the ones suffering, give us the ability to forgive those who hurt us, just as you did. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
They gave you gall and sour wine for your food, under the weight of the wood. Father, forgive them, they don't know what they do, under the weight of the wood.
I won't give up. I'm not going to let it end here. Father, lift me up. Give me the strength to make it just a little further. I know there's still more for me to do.
Jesus, sometimes we fall too, when we sin and do things that go against your love for us. Sometimes we feel like our problems are too much to bear and we feel like giving up. But you got up from under your cross. Always pull us up, Jesus, when we fall into sin. And when we feel like we cannot keep going, please, be by our side. Let us remember always what you went through, for us, and please forgive us, just as you did the Roman soldier. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
To gain the Lord is to gain.
Station 10, Jesus is stripped of his garments.
Take a good look at me. I am a thief. I rob people who ever had a chance. I feel no sorrow or remorse about it. It didn't matter to me if it was against the law. I didn't really care, and I wasn't sorry. I hated the Romans for arresting me and condemning me to death. How dare they! Jesus was on the cross beside me. I see the Roman soldiers strip off his clothes and make fun of him. But Jesus didn't reply to them back. Why? If he was so great, why didn't he free himself and me? I want to be free! I'm so angry!
My body is hurt, and now they seek to humiliate me in front of everyone. They have taken everything from me that protects me and keeps me warm. All I have now is myself.
Jesus, it must have hurt a lot to be pushed around by the soldiers and made fun of, even by other criminals. But you showed us how to love and how to forgive. Teach us to be patient with our own hurts and troubles. And help us, unlike the thief, to ask for forgiveness for our sins. Help us to be slow to anger. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
I used to rob people from their homes until I was caught and condemned to die next to that carpenter from Nazareth. I watched the soldiers nail Jesus to his cross from mine, and I was surprised to hear Jesus say,
"Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing."
I could see that Jesus was unlike anyone I had ever known. He was so wonderful, so kind. Even when he was being treated so terribly, at that moment, I knew that Jesus could help me too.
So I looked over and asked Jesus, "Remember me when I enter your kingdom." "Today, you will be with me in paradise."
At that moment, I became a believer. Are you?
"Forgive them, Father. They are only doing what others have told them to do. I have become a victim of accusers and abusers, standing far outside the range of these hammers and nails. For every hit, forgive them for what they do."
Jesus, you promised Dismas, the thief who was crucified with you, that he would be with you in heaven. That is where we want to go when we die too. Help us to forgive those who hurt us. Please forgive us when we hurt others. Make us always ready to be happy with you in heaven. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
See.
Station 13. Jesus' body is removed from the cross.
My name is Salome. I'm the mother of the apostles James and John. My son James ran away when the soldiers came after Jesus, but my son John and I stayed and comforted his mother Mary after the loss of her only son, and we helped take him off the cross. Most of Jesus' friends ran away, but he still forgave them. Would you have run away?
Jesus, we do not know if you would have been brave enough to stay with you until the very end. We hope we would have been. All we know is that we want to be with you every single day of our lives. We invite you into our hearts and homes and classrooms. And we ask you to make our faith stronger than that of your apostles on Good Friday. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Jesus, we believe that you stayed in the tomb only until the following Sunday. Then you rose from the dead. Thank you for dying for us and for coming back to life. You give us a reason to be happy when things do not go so well for us. You are always with us, no matter what we go through. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Especially our Holy Father, Pope Francis.
From his head,
that this has brought you closer to the actual human hardships and endurance that Jesus had to undergo while being led on the path to his death. We hope that seeing his strength will inspire all of us to endure much hardship in his name. This now concludes the Living Stations. We ask that you bow your heads now, and please join in saying one Our Father, Hail Mary, and Glory Be, thanking Jesus for what he did for us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Thank you for joining us on our journey. God bless the senior class of Holy Redeemer High School, class of 2021.